text gate. I don't know what else to call this. Because the Browns
Everything means a
GM.
gate. Like, I understand Watergate is the reference, but not everything's as big as Watergate.
Everything's a
Come on
gate,
now.
all right, Brendan? It was Deflate Gate, Text Gate. I've had like five gates already this year.
I know there's and they do it for not just sports. They do it for everything now.
It's like Hangnail Gate. It's like, oh yeah,
just
Hangnail.
We need to come up with more interesting topics. Like, I understand now we all know that gate means big controversy reveal, but come on, better naming. Let's
Well,
we need to name this one. Give it a better name.
All right, we'll come up with it next week. I'm blank right now. I have no idea what
I don't
to
even
call
know
it
what
now.
The story's about.
All right, name it, Brennan.
Recall it right now. Text in
text
this.
jet.
I don't, text hole.
Text
That's
hole.
What it's going to call. Text hole. There we go. Text hole.
Text hole?
Yeah, why not? I don't know.
It kind of sounds dirty, man. I don't know. About that one.
It is a very dirty situation, I assume.
All right. Well, here, let's get into the situation. So, Browns GM Ray Farmer just recently admitted that he was sending text messages during one of their games down to the sidelines. More specifically, they believe he was sending text messages to the quarterback's coach. Now, what these text messages were, nobody's quite sure, or at least they haven't released exactly what they were, but it is strictly prohibited by the NFL for ownership or like GMs or any of that to be texting the sidelines during games. Now, it's easy enough to get around that. You see Jerry Jones on the sidelines all the time, and he's the owner slash general manager, so I guess you could just walk down there if you didn't want to get in trouble for this. But, yeah, apparently texting down there is a big no-no. And they're looking at penalties. They might get fined, might lose a late-round draft pick, which just I can't imagine what he's texting would really, you know, again, walk down to the field and say whatever you have to say. You are allowed. You are the GM. I'm sure they'll let you on the field. But, yeah, I can't imagine what he could have been texting the quarterback's coach when their quarterback play was so bad. Maybe that was why this year.
You could tell he was managing the plays.
He was like, call this play. Call it now.
Like, or maybe he was talking and was like, they're getting better. Stop screwing up.
You better watch your back. I'm going to fire you if he doesn't play better. I don't quite know what he could have been saying to him. So that's kind of interesting. Now, and I don't quite understand why it has to be prohibited. Like, you're not allowed to make phone calls or stuff like that. But again, these guys are allowed to walk onto the field. So nobody's going to say, nobody ever says to Jerry Jones, don't you? Can't go talk to your coaches in the middle of the game. Now, I don't believe he does, and that might be a rule against that too, because if that is, I don't know, hit me up, let me know. But I don't believe it is a rule that if they're on the field, they can't talk to the coaches. But they're not allowed to text out, so I don't know. But we'll see what...
Are they allowed to talk to anyone? Well, I guess they have to be allowed to talk to people, because reporters talk to them all the time, right?
Not during the game. Reporters might get them.
They'll do it at like halftime,
in the quarter or halftime. Basketball is more quarters. Football is more halftimes going in and out. But usually not during the game. So now the reporters do talk
maybe
to like
no
training
one's
staff
to talk
and
to
everything
them.
Like that to get injury reports. So
that might be an exception because that's considered part of the staff. Like, you might not be able to talk to people technically outside of the game staff.
Yeah,
I don't know. I guess we could look that up. Find
yeah,
out
I think
sometimes.
It's
hey, someone else. Knows.
I don't think you should text down to the field during the middle of a game if you're a GM. It's just like, let them do what they're doing.
I don't see how it's
going to
help.
Reason they're there, but I don't see it could how it could have helped. But I don't really.
Unless you assume
why.
That the GM's a better coach, in which case, why wouldn't you just make
exactly? Why wouldn't he be coaching?
I guess because GM's a higher position, but
yeah, kind of a different position. GMs aren't usually paid more than the head coaches, so...
GMs aren't usually coaching kind of people.
Yeah,
so.
They're usually talent evaluators who put together a team, so... I don't know, hit me up, let me know what you think about... are we really going to call it text hole? All right, text hole. Brennan's
right.
Nodding yes.
I'll go with, like, text line, but that doesn't really get the darkness across.
How about text fall?
Text fall? I go with text fall.
All right, text fall. All right, let us know what you think about text fall. Hit us up, comments down below. And if I'm really being stupid about these rules and there you can think of a really good reason why they shouldn't text down to the sidelines, hit me up, let me know. Comments
now,
down
if
below.
If you think that text hole is better than text fall, let us know. Or we could go with text fall.
We can go with either one. It's up in the air.
You know
right
what?
Now.
Just hashtag both of them
yep.
in everything you talk
there you
about.
There you go. Hashtag it. Let's make it trend. But yeah, hit us up. Comments down below. Of course, @WordsmyFace on Twitter. Google Plus, Facebook. Always good ways getting a hold of us.